I don't really know what I'm doing. Can you tell? I have no idea. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I thought, let's have some fun with makeup. Let's kind of revisit my favorites from last year. So I pulled up my favorites video from March last year. I will link it underneath the cards and down in the description box. And I kind of, well, basically pulled everything that was my favorite then and I plopped it on my face. Yeah, that is it. I did not have everything. I thought I did, but apparently I didn't. And I kind of forgot something as well. It was not a complete full face. So yeah, I pulled in some products that I'm loving right now. Everything will be listed down in the description box. And if you want to see how I created this and what goodies I used, grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because here it comes. So, last month's favorites. The only thing I didn't have was a primer, so let me just grab a primer that I want to use with that one. I think I want my... Yeah, because the foundation I'm going to use later is a little bit more full coverage. I kind of want to use my glowier primer, so this is the Catrice Tensational. Let's plop it on the face. Now, the only thing I don't have, or at least I cannot find, is the under eye primer that I used from Catrice in that period of time. I thought I still had it, but I cannot find it. So yeah, there's that. So I don't have an under eye primer. Just so you know. So my face is primed. Lately, I kind of like doing my eyes first. So what I have is still my favorite concealer. It's the Catrice One Drop Liquid Coverage. I'm going to shake it and I'm going to kind of do it. That part already. So I just kind of even out my skin tone a little bit. A little bit above my brow, so I don't have to put a lot of foundation there later and mess up my brow again. And then just a tiny bit underneath my eye. Okay, let's kind of tap it in a little. And then I'm basically ready for brows. Now for brows, I had the Catrice Brow Pencil that I have here, that I still love to death and use every single time I do my brows. That's basically every day, unless I really don't want to do anything. So let me just kind of quickly, hopefully, let's see if I can get them at least in the same family today. They always say that brows should be like, what is it, sisters, not twins, or something along those lines. Well, mine are sometimes, you know, I don't know, one is the weird cousin or something, you know. So I am kind of in pre-filming mode. I don't know when this video will go up, but I wanted to film and I thought, let's do something fun, you know. At least looking like the same family. What I'm going to do now is I have a brow product from Douglas, the Brow Definer Eyebrow Modeling Gel in dark brown. It's just like, you know, yeah, it's, I'm using it because I have it. I want to finish it up. It's a nice gel, guys. I don't know what to say about it. Okay, now if I don't forget, I will put in a clear gel later, but I probably will forget, just so you know. So brows are kind of done. I didn't have an eye base. Let me check. Apparently I did not have a favorite eyeshadow base. I do now, so let me get it. Where's my glitter primer here? And that is my favorite now, is the Kiko Milano eye base. So let's combine them. Why are you dirty? It's going to be one of those days, I think. Now, for eyeshadow palette, my favorite last year in the month of March was the Dream with a Vision from Makeup Obsession. And I haven't used her in a long, long time. This is what she looks like. It was actually my first pastel palette. They are not only pastels in here, but they're also kind of bright in here. The quality is really, really good. It was also my first Makeup Obsession palette. So yeah, I just don't really know what I kind of wanted to do today. I don't know. I kind of want to use this one called Aspiration and maybe Sunshine. I kind of want to use the teal, so I will play there somewhere. I don't know. What do I want to start with? I think I want to start with the yellow. And I want to start with the yellow in the inner eye part area region. So I have a brush. This is the, what is it? The 231 Luxe Petite Crease from Yesup. I'm going to grab the color Sunshine, which is this one. I am going to work on both sides because I'm working with pastels. In my opinion, most pastels benefit from a sticky base. I'm not really prone to setting my eyeshadow base anyway, but pastels really benefit from it. I don't know, maybe that is fun. So I'm actually going to pull it around my eye a little bit more. Because apparently I'm in a yellowish, pastel yellow mood today. Okay, let's get a different brush. For... what's the color that I want? Aspiration? And then maybe Skylight on the bottom? I don't know. Let's go to this one. Called Aspiration. I don't really know what I'm doing. Can you tell? I have no idea. Now, I kind of left space for this shade because theoretically they kind of should muddy up a little bit. But it could very well be that it is not as noticeable because the shades are so light. I actually remember not really having a problem with muddying shades in this palette. It's actually really cute, this. I feel like an Easter egg. Okay, I'm cleaning my brush and going back to the yellow. Just to make sure that it is a little bit more blended here. Now, I am really packing it on, but that is because they are so light. And maybe my base wasn't tacky enough to really grab hold of the shadows. But I do think this is cute. I kind of wanted to use the teal as well. I can use the teal underneath my eye. So let me grab my teal pencil from BH Cosmetics. What I'm going to do first though is I'm going to grab a different brush and a little bit more of my eyeshadow primer. So not my shimmer, but my eyeshadow primer. I'm going to put it on the back of my hand, grab a little, and then put it basically on my lash line. Because I want the teal matte there, but I want it to stick as best as possible. Let me go into my shade and grab it. It's actually kind of cute, this, guys. Or at least I think so. Do I want a shimmery goodness? Let's see what I have. Yeah, but that is too purple. I don't really want that. This is probably too blue. Yeah. I think I'm going to grab the white in here with a fluffy brush. So let me grab the color Cloud. With a fluffy brush, and I'm going to dust it over. It's also a gorgeous face highlight, by the way. Let's start here in the beginning. I think my brush is too big. Yep. So let's go back to my Morphe then. And I'm going to go back in the yellow. I do have a pink shimmer in here called Fantasy. I'm working with fluffy brush because I want to keep the pastel thingy going. So just still this same brush. Oh, this is cute. Now, I don't have a teal, light teal shimmer in here. I do have a light blue shimmer in here, but I'm afraid that it will kind of change everything. So let me grab... Let's see what I can do with my BH palette. Yeah, I have a greeny shimmer in here, which is Double Take, this one, which has a slight green shift. So let me get the brush I used. And tap, let's see. Just going to dust it over. Yeah, because I kind of want a shimmery lower lash line. You don't have to do this, but I kind of like it. I'm only missing a little bit there. What do I want there? Ooh, that's nice. So I'm still in the same color that I just used, but I'm now bringing it in a little bit more. Oh, that's cute. Then let's, for funsies, because I can, grab this one, top it off, which is a little bit, yeah, orangey. Same brush. I cannot believe that I don't even know if I ever mentioned this palette, the one that I'm using now. In a favorite, if you like multi-chromes, but you don't know which one you want, or if you like it, or whatever, or maybe they are just too expensive, grab this one. This is such a good palette. Mm. Okay, I think the eyes are largely done. I really like how this turned out. I really, really like it. Maybe I want a little bit more yellow, but I will see when the rest of my face is on. And I'm going to do that now. So let me close this one. Or shall I kind of finish off the eyes first? Let me get some coffee and think about it. Let me finish off the eyes first. I did not mention any liner or mascara. I did mention falsies. So I'm going to put on liner and mascara. And then I will be back. Okay. My favorite falsies last year were the Kylie style that I have here in a box. But I also... Is this the Kylie style? Yeah. I have them here in a box. So let me put those on as well, before we go to the rest of the face. With the glue that I kind of just discovered then, which is the Eyelure Lash Glue. I still use it, and I really, really like it. It is actually still my favorite lash glue. So yeah, if you want to know how I put on my falsies, there's a video down in the description box. But let me put them on real quick, and then we can go on with the rest of the video. Oh, if you hear anything, my washing machine is doing its thing. These are actually not the falsies I would have chosen for this look. But yeah, they were favorites of last year in the month of March. So what can you do about it? They are on. I feel kind of ridiculous, but it is going to work out eventually, I hope. Let's grab foundation. And my foundation, favorite foundation March last year, was this one. The PS My Perfect Color Double Coverage Matte Foundation from Primark. In the shade beige. Now, I also have nude beige here. Or was it the shade nude beige? What was it? Oh, no. It was beige. But I think I'm a little bit too pale for... just beige, so I can kind of mix them together a bit. So yeah, I have here one of those things, and I'm just going to mix a little bit together. Oh yeah, they don't come with a pump, but I just put a pump from another foundation on this one. From, I think it was one from LA Girl actually, that kind of fit. So I'm just going to mix the two shades a little bit. Yeah, that's kind of okay. Let's use this new sponge. I have a video on my channel comparing this one to the Estée Lauder Double Wear. If I don't forget, I will link it. They are very close. The Estée Lauder is a little bit more coverage. It looks a little bit more pretty on the skin, which it should, because it costs 10 times as much. But if you want to know if you like that foundation and you have a Primark and it sells this one and you can find your shade, try this one. It's really, really close. And it looks very pretty on the skin. The only thing that I kind of don't like about this foundation and the Double Wear is that it kind of settles, especially here in those smile lines that I have. Well, I don't know if there are lines or more like, I don't know, Grand Canyons. I don't know, people. But yeah, that's the only thing that I... kind of dislike about either foundation, but maybe that is the way that I set my makeup. I don't know, or maybe I don't know. They are just, I know. And what I like about this is that you can build it up to full if you want to, but you can also shear it out by just using a little bit less. Ah, well, I'll wear a scarf and you won't notice. Okay, concealer. So I just need a little bit. I really just need a little bit. So I have, I think this is even too much. Okay, now I'm going to go over it with my sponge. Just to make sure that it is nice and blended and such. Okay, now what I do now, and I really, really love, is cream bronzer and cream blush. I didn't do that last year. I just recently started doing that, so let me get them. They're the same that I use every single time I do this. Because I'm still waiting for my ColourPop blush, and it's the only bronzing stick that I have. But let me contour and cream contour, cream blush, and then powder and bronze my face, because I do have a favorite blush, but the rest I don't. So let me do that off camera and I will be right back. Okay, ready for blush. I did add a little bit of yellow there, just so you know. So I had mentioned these two, the floral blushes from BH Cosmetics, one in the color Fiji Fun, which looks like this, and the other one in Caribbean Coral, which looks like this. So these are the two blushes that I mentioned, and let's go for this one. So let's get a fluffy brush. They are pretty, pretty pigmented, so I am going to kind of swirl. Also, the shade called Fantasy is a very pretty pink shimmer blush, or the shade Fantasy from the eyeshadow palette, I mean. And I use this with a fluffy brush because they are pretty heftily pigmented. Especially the Fiji Fun is. Okay, let's kind of clean the head a little. And let's tone it down just a tad. So let me get my Kiko Milano Skin Finish and a fluffy brush. Just go over everything, and this is how I use a skin finish, because it buffs everything together a bit, and this one creates a very subtle extra sheen on the face. Okay, I use that one, a little setting spray. Oh no, I forgot my... Oh, I lied. I said I didn't have a primer, didn't I? I did. I had this one. That I still really love. I think this is my third top. I just forgot. I forgot. So sorry about that. So yeah. Okay then. Anyway, I am ready for lips. And for lips I had four. I had these four. I had my NYX Cookie Butter. I had the L'Oreal Rouge Signature in I Empower. And I had two turned ups from NYX. One in the color Stone and one in the color Mirage. Let me think. This one could be cute. This one is also cute. I think I'm going to wear this one because I haven't worn it in quite a while. So let me put it on. And then that is it. This is the final look. I like it. I feel ready for spring now. I hope that the weather will kind of happen. It was very, very fun to kind of revisit everything that I loved last year in March. I'm very happy that I got to play with this palette again, because it has been quite a while and I really like what... well, what I created. For the rest, I use the stuff that I used today still. Some not as often as others, but yeah, I still use everything today. I still love everything today. This foundation, I still love. It's not my favorite anymore, but I still really love it. So yeah, guys, I think that was it. Everything I used today will be listed down in the description box. Let me know what you think of this look. Do you have anything that I mentioned today? And I will also link my favorite video from last year, so you can check out everything that I talked about there. That was it. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Before you leave, leave me a comment down below. It will help me out tremendously. And I am going to sign off. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. And I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.